environmental conservation, cultural and historic preservation, protection of endangered species. All these issues are important to our world, and they're important to the Federal Highway Administration as well. FHWA has established Everyday Counts, an initiative designed to identify and deploy innovation aimed at shortening project delivery, enhancing the safety of our roadways, and protecting the environment. Programmatic agreements focus on streamlining the process of handling routine environmental requirements for common project types.
Programmatic agreements are documents which detail how agencies are going to interact with one another to address specific issues. In the transportation area, these often are with agencies where consultation is occurring between the DOT and the resource agency. And the programmatic agreement may outline how that consultation is going to occur, what measures may be taken to help streamline that consultation.
The benefits of using programmatic agreements are numerous. They streamline the review process, help minimize the impact on the environment, and focus on preservation and conservation rather than paperwork. But just as important, they shorten project delivery time, which in turn saves time and money.
Government agencies are being required to reduce their staffs. They're being required to try to do more with less. And programmatic agreements fit right in with that philosophy. We have to find ways to work smarter, not harder. And by doing that, that's the only way that we're really going to be able to meet the expectations of the public, which is that we deliver our projects in a more timely fashion and we do it less expensively. We have to learn to do more with less, and programmatic agreements are a way of doing that.
In Kentucky, programmatic agreements were critical in streamlining a bridge replacement over Flat Creek in Franklin County. This project also shows how multiple programmatic agreements may be used for one project.
On that particular project, it's a small bridge replacement project out in a rural area. And we used the categorical exclusion agreement, developing what we call a CE1, level one. So by definition, that does not have to be approved by Federal Highway Administration. It's done entirely internal to the cabinet. We used the Indiana Bat Conservation Fund. We made a payment. There were a few trees that were around the bridge. And rather than doing any type of species surveys that would have cost us thousands of dollars, we made a small payment into the Indiana Bat Conservation Fund. So that saved us the time of having to do those surveys. Then finally, we used our Section 106 programmatic agreement on that project so that the documentation that was prepared was able to be done by our own staff rather than hiring a consultant to develop a lengthy report.
The Federal Highway Administration encourages every state to adopt the use of programmatic agreements and see how they can be used effectively to accelerate project delivery.
I think the best way to encourage participation and development of new programmatic agreements is to get examples out in front of people. It's not that they don't want to do something, it's that they don't know that it's there for them to do. So if you can plant the seed, get the idea out in front of them, make them aware that there's a possibility of doing something, that'll oftentimes start to create the idea that they can move forward.
Programmatic agreements clearly offer many advantages for state DOTs.
There's no question that the use of these programmatic agreements have improved the efficiency and effectiveness of our program. We're able to work through what are sometimes complicated processes in a much more efficient way, to reach final decisions much more quickly than we would be otherwise if we were using what might be considered more traditional methods.